telescope lens. Why would he lock that up? Whoa, what's going on? It's dialing in something all on its own and it's showing the way to another memory? Where is that?
Another world seeping into DeSeto. Was this a taste of that mysterious tearaway?
Thank you.
Here we go.
I'm glad to see you made it. I had my doubts, but the hope you instilled has yet abandoned me.
I guess this must be Tarawea.
Who are you?
My name is Juan Luis Jorge, and this is indeed the convent of Tarawea. You'll have to excuse me, but Jeremy never got your name.
The name's Edward Carnby. I'm a private investigator. You're not a patient, are you?
No. I'm the author of a book that Jeremy once found important.
How does that work? Are you part of this memory as well? Is this even a memory?
I think calling me a manifestation of Jeremy's subconscious would be more correct. And so is the convent of Tarawea. I'm a man Jeremy has never met. And we are in a place that he has never been.
Okay. So are you here to guide me or something?
I have no more purpose than you do. I simply am. I will happily help you, of course, if I'm able.
If you are already somehow part of Jeremy, why did he want to come here? Isn't he sort of here already?
Jeremy wanted to come here because it's a representation of his mind at peace. When Dr. Gray asks him to find his focus during his sessions, this far-flung convent is what Jeremy imagines. He is under the impression that if he could physically come here, he would reach a perfect equanimity. A spiritual apotheosis.
You don't think it would work?
Jeremy subconsciously knows it's just wishful thinking. He can't come here. Despite the pathways opened by the dark man between Derceto and Jeremy's psyche, it's simply not possible.
But I'm here.
Indeed. It's a shame it's just another place for you, Detective. Otherwise, you could have become a Buddha.
Always a bridesmaid, never a blushing bride. Am I right?
Yes, I suppose so. You'll have to chase enlightenment elsewhere.
So what's the next best thing? What can I do here?
You should seek out the convent library and try to find the truth about Jeremy's relationship with the dark man. It's the sort of knowledge he represses and is unable to reflect on.
Will it tell me how to break the pact?
Perhaps. At least you'll have something to confront Jeremy with.
Wait, why can't you just tell me?
I don't know such things. You'd be better off consulting the text of Dr. Freud if you want such answers.
No thanks, I hate shrinks.
There is another thing you should know about the library. He is here as well. The dark man has been working his way through the text for a long, long time.
He's here? How am I supposed to get past him?
Be careful, Detective.
Oh, jeez. Just perfect. You have any advice on how to deal with the dark man?
I suppose suppression could work. Try not to pay him any attention. Ugh.
Oh.
There's something missing.
The great library was endless. Beautiful and terrible. An Akashic record for the universe inside the mind of Jeremy Hartwood, now corrupted by a story forced upon him, told by a maniacal liar, an evil conjured by science and secrecy. I will suspend a room and lock away the foundation of his character. Its key will be left to the librarian, the only thing invisible to the prowler.
It was in the hot autumn that I went through the night with the restless crowds. He was a kind of itinerant showman who held forth in public halls and aroused widespread fear. The New Orleans address of the event is lost, but I remember distinctly the Prext Shipping Company pressing their contribution. Hey.
Detective!
What?
I hope you found what you were looking for. I fear there is no going back.
I was so close. There must be something I can work with. Come on, Carmby, think. Think! Shipping company. Prext. Right.
Good luck, detective.
Well, thank God you're here, detective. Sitting all alone in a place like this. I'd never live it down if the papers got wind of it.
Hey, Ruth, right?
Oh, don't pretend you don't know. I'm sure you have a whole file on me by now, Detective. I suppose we weren't formally introduced. I'm Ruth Talon, Miss Ruth Talon, in case you're wondering.
Edward Carmby.
Enchanté.
Are you sure?
I had too many already.
Nice. It's good.
I know. I have great taste, Detective. I heard you're trying to break Jeremy's promise to the dark man.
Yeah. Do you know anything about that kind of stuff?
No. But it makes you wonder if he made a promise. Can't he simply stand by his words?
Look, I'm just trying to get Jeremy out of a bad deal, so he'll come back with us to New Orleans.
Well, if all fails.
What are you doing?
It's a sign of submission to the dark man. I saw it in a dream once.
What? You don't know the Prext Shipping Company by any chance?
I do. They made big money during the war. But their waterfront office is just over there.
How did you do that?
Do what, detective? Bonne chance.
Hey, have you seen Emily Hartwood anywhere?
Are you trying to make me jealous, detective? No, I haven't seen your doll anywhere.
Shipping company. According to the book in Tarawea, the Dark Man is connected to a performance that Jeremy went to somewhere in New Orleans. I'm sure I can find the address inside. It's locked from the other side.
Ah.
sewer system has a tunnel running right below Preg's shipping company. I bet I can use it to get inside.
Thank you.
No way I can get this out of the way with my bare hands. But if I get that crane going, that should do it.
Inside the warehouse. The office must be upstairs.
I just wanted to try one of these.
The ship was raided while in dock. All of his things were recovered, but blood was shed. Several men were carried into the Mississippi River and drowned by ones who live in the deep. All items have now been signed and delivered. Now best keep the papers safe. What is left? later is right, and hell is back again. Cargo Manifesto, September 19th, 1892. Breck Shipping Company delivered 4 steamer trunks, 1 Egyptian sarcophagus, and a large wooden crate belonging to the showman called the Black Pharaoh, performing at 18th Street.
Here we go. The address where Jeremy first encountered the Dark Man.
Looks like the fog cleared up. You want to tell me what this is all about?
Welcome, Detective, to the greatest show this side of the Mississippi. Nyarlathotep, the Black Pharaoh, the ancient magician who lived 1,000 lives and wore 1,000 masks.
I can see why you settled on calling him the Dark Man. Saves your breath. So, you got scared by a stage magician. And now he's living inside your head.
You can mock me, Detective. You would be the crazy one to think his presence can be ignored. Look where we are!
We didn't get to finish our last conversation, did we? You were about to tell me how to break the contract with the Dark Man.
No. Can't. We would turn loose on the world. So many innocent would die.
But there is a way to break out of the deal.
There is. He offered me a way out. Steps to take.
What are they?
You'll never find them. They're forever entombed in his sunken desert temple.
Jeremy, I'm not your enemy. Tell me where to go. How do I find the temple?
No, we can't. I have to make this sacrifice.
God damn it, Jeremy. I'm gonna save you. Don't worry.
How do you save someone who doesn't want to be saved? Well, he's gonna get saved no matter what. I just need to find the temple somehow. Sunken desert temple. I better get down there. This is it. This is where the contract is hidden. But how do I get to it?
Thank you.
assume it's operational. Thank you. ready to collapse. Acknowledge psychological trauma, break through barriers of self-deceit, temper-manic behavior. These are the Dark Man's terms. The contract. Huh? Found some.
Great. Was it alcohol?
God, no. I just got the wind knocked out of me. I think I know how to break the contract with the Dark Man.
What exactly does that mean?
Everything going back to normal.
All right. I found some more information on Dorsetto and the patients. There are some seriously strange things going on here. I'm pretty sure two of the patients are dead, and maybe even the clerk.
Oh, yeah. I kind of just gave up on worrying about that.
Well... just keep your eyes open, I suppose. What were you doing again?
Jeremy made a pact with the Dark Man to keep all the madness locked inside Dorsetto.
All right.
I'm gonna break it. I just have to... where is it? Where's the talisman?
It's around your neck.
Ah! Ah!
I worry, Detective.
Don't. I'm fine.
I worry that you're not much help on this case. At least you're a good distraction.
Trust me. You're getting your money's worth. At this rate, I'm an absolute bargain.